The address function allows you to create as text a reference to a cell. So what does that mean? Basically here we have a cell in cell B4. What we want to do is create out of some key inputs where that cell is to be used in other formulas. So here we're told that the column for this reference is number 2, the row is 4, and it's on sheet 1. We can make use of the address function. So if we go, you go into the lookup and reference category, you'll find address, and I say OK. And you'll see it asks for a number of items. The first thing it asks for is the row number. So what we want to show, we can see it's in row 4, so we can either type in a 4, or else in this case I'm going to link it to that cell. You'll see a 4 pops up there. The next thing it asks for is the column number. So what column is it? 1, 2. Again, I'm going to link it to this cell. You'll see immediately it's already got here $B$4. The next item, absolute numbers, specifies the reference type. So you'll see if you type a 1 in there, it's absolute. So when I type a 1 in, it stays as is. There's a dollar sign in front of the B and the 4. If it's a 2, you've got an absolute row and a relative column. So let me put a 2 in. And you'll see that the row is anchored, but the column moves, and so on. So if you put a 3 in, it's the other way around, and a 4, there's no relative or absolute references. So I'm going to leave it like that. The next item, if you want to enter it, is the style. So if you want a letter and a number style, you put a 1 in, or you omit it. If you want the row 1, column 1 style, you put a 0 in. So if I put a 0 in here, you'll see the referencing changes. I'm going to go back to a 1. And the sheet text is the sheet that you want to specify. Again, you can type it in, or else in this case, I'm going to click on there. And when I say OK, you'll see in text format, it gives me a reference to a cell, which I can now use in other functions, such as the indirect function. Now that we have this formula set up, it's very easy to change what is shown here. So for example, let's say we don't want to look on sheet 1, but let's pretend there was a sheet 2. I can come here, change that to sheet 2, say OK. And now our reference here changes to sheet 2, cell B4. And if we had other formulas linked to it, such as the indirect formula, that would affect those formulas. So this function allows you to get out of Excel the exact reference syntax so that you can use it in other formulas.